Recorded Books presents an unabridged recording of Mr. Potter and Tabby Run the Race by Cynthia Rylant, narrated by John McDonough and directed by Lynn Flanagan.
Chapter 1. Find Your Sneakers. It was April. Mr. Potter and his fine cat, Tabby, were full of April energy. They always got extra energy in April. Flowers were blooming, birds were singing, showers were showering. April! Mr. Potter and Tabby felt it. Mrs. Teaberry next door must have felt it too. She called Mr. Potter one April morning. "There's a race," she said. "A race?" asked Mr. Potter. "A marathon," said Mrs. Teaberry. "Uh-oh," thought Mr. Potter. He was sure Mrs. Teaberry was going to ask him to run the race with her. "Will you run the race with me?" asked Mrs. Teaberry. Mr. Potter gave Tabby more cream. "Aren't we too old to run a race?" asked Mr. Potter. "It's a senior marathon," said Mrs. Teaberry. "Nothing but old people." Mr. Potter gave Tabby another biscuit. "I have not run anywhere in 30 years," said Mr. Potter. "I don't think I remember how to run." "There are prizes," said Mrs. Teaberry. "Prizes?" asked Mr. Potter. Mr. Potter loved prizes. "One is a train set," said Mrs. Teaberry. "Really?" asked Mr. Potter. "With lights and switches and tunnels," said Mrs. Teaberry. "Really?" asked Mr. Potter again. "The train set is second prize," Mrs. Teaberry said. Mr. Potter could not imagine a train set being second prize. It should be first. "What is first prize?" asked Mr. Potter. "Golf clubs," said Mrs. Teaberry. Mr. Potter did not play golf. He had tried once, but he and Tabby kept getting lost. Mr. Potter did not want golf clubs. "I want that train set," said Mr. Potter. "I knew you would," said Mrs. Teaberry. "Find your sneakers." Chapter 2. Toes and Tea. Mr. Potter started training for the marathon. It was not easy. It took him 4 days just to find his sneakers. Then he had to work out. Mr. Potter did not want to work out. He wanted to eat muffins with Tabby. But he knew that Mrs. Teaberry was working out, because sometimes her good dog, Zeke, ran by with a jump rope in his mouth. When Zeke wanted to play, he took things and ran. So Mr. Potter had to work out too. He decided he would touch his toes 30 times every day, to make up for the 30 years he'd forgotten to run. The first time Mr. Potter tried to touch his toes, he could not reach them. He touched his knees instead. He touched his knees twice, and then he had a cup of tea with Tabby. The next time Mr. Potter tried to touch his toes, he tried 10 times, and he never got there. But he enjoyed his tea with Tabby very much, and he decided knees were just fine. Zeke kept running by with his jump rope. Mr. Putter kept touching his knees, and Tabby had lots of tea.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.